Hello friends, this is Sanjay again, and today we'll be talking about how you can get jobs on Upwork, how you can earn money on Upwork, and how you can work as a freelancer on Upwork. So friends, last time in one of the videos I talked about how you can get freelancers. So that is in perspective of when you are a client and looking for someone to work for you. But here, if you want to make money on Upwork, then you need to work as a freelancer and you need to register yourself as a freelancer. So you are seeing the Upwork homepage here, and here you have a option called become a freelancer. So if you don't have, if you have not created your profile, then you can click on this and create your profile. So once you click on become a freelancer, here you can create your own profile and then login. And if you already have account, then you can just click and then press on login. So on your successful login, you will see this screen, and on the right hand side you will see your profile. So let us first see what you can write in your profile and how the clients can see your profile. So first of all, let us go to view my profile. So this is my profile that I have created in 2014. So here, if you see, you can see your name, your picture, then your location from where you are working on, the local time there, as well as the skills that you want to highlight for you. You can also put in your hourly rate, and you need to put in overview, what are the skills that you have, how you can help client to accomplish his work. And below you can see the work history, how much you have earned till now, what all projects you have done. So as you can see, I have done quite a lot of projects, and there are some good feedbacks, remarks from the clients. And then yeah, if you are allowed to put some of the portfolios, then you can put it here, any certifications that you have done, any tests you have done, what's your employment history, your experience, and all about. Again, on the right hand side, you see what is the success rate, how much hours you have worked on, how many jobs you have completed, what is your availability, response time, and yeah, what's the languages that you are fluent in. So all those details you can see here. You can also click as view my profile as others see it. So this is the view how the client will see your profile. Yeah, so you can see all these details that are there on the page. Now once you build up your complete profile, then you can start looking for a job. So first of all, if your profile is very good, then you don't have to beg for a job. Yeah, you can choose your own clients, and if you are choosing your own clients, then you can charge money and you can have your hourly rates higher. So for that, definitely you should have a good profile, and then you should provide the suggestions whenever a client comes to you and contacts you, and you should understand his requirements well and all those things. Now I'll show you how you can find the job. So there is a tab here, find jobs. Once you click on that, yeah, based on your profile and your skill set, you will see some of the similar jobs that matches your skills here in the window. Yeah, so if you are a, like for me, I'm a WPF programmer, so you see here jobs that are related to WPF, UI, XAML, all those are popping up. But if you want to look for a particular job, then yeah, you can search for it. You can go to advanced search, type in all skill search, title search. So yeah, that will help you to find a relevant job for you, and then you can apply on it. So let's say, let's open one of the jobs that is posted here. So once I open this, you can see that it's mainly for entry level, and the client is looking for lower rates, and he's looking who can work for 30 hours or around, and this job is around 3 to 6 months. You can see the client reviews here and the location of the client, how much is number of jobs he has posted, how much is the amount he has spent, and what is the hourly rate he is paying. So from this rate, yeah, you can guess whether this client will be willing to pay you more, or yeah, you need to bid less in order to just get a client. So it depends. It depends on your needs and your qualifications. Below you can see what are the other jobs he has posted and similar jobs on Upwork if you are interested in this category of job. And once you see, okay, yeah, you are good to go to work on this job, then you can click on submit a proposal if you want to apply for it, or you can save this job as a bookmark and then later you can again have a look and submit your proposal. So let's click on submit a proposal. So once you go here, you can see the proposed terms and hourly rate, what you want to charge. So you can increase it, decrease it as per, yeah, you can increase it or decrease it. And then you need to put in your cover letter. So that means you need to write down what you can do, how you can help the client to finish this job. Do you have any better idea? And if you need some more information, you can provide your Skype ID or your contact number, anything like that. You can also attach your resume or other documents if you want to share, and then click on submit a proposal, and then your client will get notification that someone has applied for this job, and then he can contact you. Yeah. You can also choose categories, like if you are on admin support, customer service. So there are a lot of categories which I showed in my previous videos, and then yeah, you can apply for any job relevant category. You also have a filters here, your experience level, project length, you want to do it per hour or it's a fixed budget. So all those filters you can choose and then look at it. Save jobs here, as I just now mentioned, all jobs that you save to have a look later will appear here. And then if you go to the proposals, you can find what are the active offers, what are the active jobs that you have applied, any invitations that you have got, or any submitted proposals. Under archived, you can see the jobs and all that you have previously applied or you have been interviewed. Profile I already shared with you. If you go to my stats, here you can see the satisfaction, client satisfaction, how much is there, how much is your communication, you reply within a day or you reply every time. So all those details you can see here. And then yeah, I'll suggest that you give most of the tests that are recommended for you, because some of the clients really needs this, that you have completed these tests and then there are higher chances that you easily get a job. So friends, this is a very, very nice way to show your skills and get some part-time work. Some of the people have made it full-time because they don't want to work 9 to 5, and then you can sit at home and work whenever you want. So most of the time the job is offered to you, and then you have a dedicated time when you have to finish it. Yeah, and then you can share your results. You can show to a demo using some Skype or some online tools to your client, and then chat with them and show your progress. So there is messages section, and under this messages section you have all messages that you have sent to your client. You can also share the code that you have built in and all those information. Okay, so friends, it's a good platform to work and show your skills and earn money. So yeah, if you have any questions, just put in the comments below. I'll be happy to reply them. Subscribe to my channel. There are a lot more to come about Upwork. Thank you.